All right, well, hey, thanks. This is Jeff Eckerle. I'm the co-founder of an internal startup from Dell Tech called Kona.com. Mark Nutter is here with me. He's going to talk a little bit about the tech, but I'm going to give you a whirlwind tour here of this product. So there's really three layers to Kona, and the first is all about being a place for people to stay connected and get things done. So I know you're saying, oh, that's Basecamp, right? Well, and there's lots of people that are trying to build a better Basecamp, and I'm going to show you why we think Kona is something you should take a look at. So first of all, this is the space where a group of people have come together. And the first thing we've done differently here is we've tried to make it conversation-centric. So I see there's people, there's conversations, there's tasks, but when I click on conversations, now I'm seeing the conversations around a topic, around an image, around a task, around a calendar event. And I can, you know, hop into one of these and see, you know, all the communication that's happened, captured, and put together with files, and then done it around the permissioning system that allows us to put subgroups within a space. So we don't have to have, you know, everybody seeing this. We can control if we want the client to see something or not. Still have them in this collaboration space together. But it's also a task management application for a group of people. So we have task lists, we have, you know, who's here, we have tags, and I can, you know, hop into one and look at the city permit appeal task. The conversation is all there with the file. We've got who it's assigned to, William Apple, and then some people are following it. And this one's public, so everyone can see this in the space, even if they're not actually a part of it. So we can do the same thing for events, but the main gist of this first layer of Kona is that it's a place for people to collaborate. But what we wanted to do is look at kind of team collaboration and say, well, why do people struggle? And it's usually because we build project management apps and then push them down on all the people. So what would it look like if we built a collaboration application for, you know, everybody that's on the team? And that's what this view shows you is the My Kona view, where here, now this is a space that's oriented around me and all the different groups of people that I'm part of. So, you know, I can get to that same conversation right from here if I want to, or I can see all my tasks across all my spaces. I can see events that are coming in across all my spaces. So it's really my place to be personally productive across everything that I'm doing in Kona. And I'm in control here. So unlike email, I can mute conversations, I can leave spaces, I can hide spaces. It really puts the individual in control. But if you're really trying to build something for an individual, we got to recognize that people come to work with their whole lives in their head, right? So I actually have a personal life, and I find myself trying to get things done in groups there too. So here's an example where I recently put a sport court in my backyard, and you know, I needed to have the contractor collaborate on a lot of things. So we set up a Kona space, and we had conversations around like the final invoice. Here was an issue with some of the concrete. We captured all that, we memorialized it all, and have a common record where we both knew everything that related to this. I have a space for my family stuff. So, you know, my wife and I don't assign her tasks, but I can ask her to do tasks. And we can communicate. She turned the sprinklers off while I was out of town earlier this week. The hockey team that I play on, I'm actually, if you can see here, there's a calendar event for just about in 2 minutes, face-off is happening. And I had to say that I wouldn't be able to make it because I was talking to you all. But you can see everybody else said they were in, and then the captain posted the lines, and then actually someone was late here and they couldn't make it. So you've got this concept of having these workspaces and personal spaces all in one place where people collaborate. Now the third layer of Kona is for the business. So we have accounts that I can come in, and now the company can control which people are part of the company account. And then these spaces can be granted ownership to the company instead of some individual that just signed up for a Basecamp account. And we have, you know, in this case, 19 spaces with 12 members. And in those spaces, we might have one called the private social network for our company. And if we look at this, here's a space called the hub that's part of a company account. And there, they're talking about things like the telecommuting chat room. So here's all the telecommuters having a conversation that's very much like a Yammer-like experience. So, just to hit home this point of conversation-centric application again, I'm going to go to this one last conversation, pull up this image, and really just try to weave this all together for you. So if you think about Kona.com, it's really combining three different categories of application into one experience for an individual user. So we have project and task management, which is for people and teams, kind of like your base camp. We've got personal productivity for the individual to want to engage and adopt the software. And for the company, we have the private social network all wrapped into one experience. And I think if you give Kona.com a try, it's free. There's also a business edition, but there's a lot of power in the free version, and you'll find no limits on people or projects like you might in Basecamp. So, Mike, Mark, tell us how we do.
All right, so I'll do the really quick whirlwind tour since I got 2 minutes here about the tech. We've got a Ruby on Rails application on the back end. We've got a large JavaScript client on the front end. We use real-time throughout WebSockets. It was a big focus for us. We wanted everything to be real-time collaboration and a big focus, like Jeff said, on conversations being the focal point. And hopefully I can switch over to the mobile app here. So, really quickly, what we've done with the mobile app we think is pretty unique. We used a native HTML5 hybrid approach because we're all web developers. We didn't want to have to write X number of applications for X number of platforms out there as the mobile industry becomes more and more fragmented. So we really wanted to make this whole hybrid HTML5 strategy work. So what we ended up doing was, for everywhere we needed to have a delightful user experience, scrolling the application, smooth animations, drawers like you've seen in apps like Facebook, and then the top and bottom native bars, we've done it all in native code because those are the areas that we really want to preserve user experience. Everything else, however, is done in the technologies and frameworks that we're comfortable in, which is HTML5, CSS3, our current favorite framework on the JavaScript land, which is AngularJS, which I strongly recommend you check out if you're a developer on the front end. And that's exactly what we have running in the middle here. Any changes we push to that application get pushed to Android and iOS at the same time. And we believe you can use HTML5 as a cross-platform development solution. We think we've actually done a pretty good job with it, and you can download the apps from the App Store on iOS and Android and see for yourself.